I extend my warm greetings to each one of you. In today's video, we are going to look at the tenses. Dear students, as you know, tenses are very important. Okay, they play a major role in English. Okay, so we need to pay here keen attention on tenses. So, what the tenses are? Why do we study tenses? So tenses are used to denote time of an action. They are used to denote time of an action, whether the action had taken place in past, present, or will take place in the future. So it tells us about the time. And do you know we have to study this keenly because most of the topics depends on tenses only. Further, we are going to study narration, okay, passive voice. They all depend on tenses only. If you have a good knowledge of tenses, these all topics will be very easy for you. So let's start the tenses. So there are three types of tenses. Everybody knows about it: present, past, and the future. And these three tenses means each tense consist of four parts. Okay. Means there will be four parts for present, for past, and for future as well. And total there will be 12 tenses. So we are going to study 12 tenses. So first of all, we are going to start present tense. We are going to start present tense. Subparts. So in present tense, we start from simple present. Simple present. First of all, we are going to look at the uses of simple present tense, and then we will see how to use simple present tense in sentences. So what's the uses of simple present tenses? So first one is we use simple present tense for universal fact. For universal fact or truths, you can say. What the universal truths are? The truths which are made by nature, we cannot change them, are called universal truths or natural facts made by nature. Like the earth goes round the sun. The earth goes round the sun. We know it. Can we stop the earth? Can anybody stop the earth? Nobody. So this is the fact. This is made by nature and it can't be changed by anyone. The next one is the sun sets in the west. You know very well the sun sets in the west. Can we change it? Can we change its direction to north, to south? No, not at all. So this is also a fact which is made by nature only, and anybody can't change it. That's why we have to make these sentences in simple present. So that was the first use of simple present tense for universal truths. We have to use simple present tense. The next one is going to be general facts or scientific facts. General facts or scientific facts. What are the general facts? Okay, the facts which cannot be changed, like 2 and 2 makes 4. Makes 4. Can you change this truth? Not at all. Okay, in past, in present, and in future, always 2 and 2 will make only 4. 2 और 2 केवल 4 ही बनाएंगे. ये एक फैक्ट है जिसे हम चेंज नहीं कर सकते. दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव टू यूज हियर सिंपल प्रेजेंट intelligent test. The next one is scientific fact. What the scientific fact is? What does science say? Science क्या कहता है हमें? Okay, these are called scientific fact. Like water freezes at the 0 degree Celsius. 0 degree Celsius. Okay, so this is this effect which is proved by science. So this is called here scientific fact. And just opposite, if we take water at 100 degree Celsius, it will start boiling. So water boils at 100 degree Celsius. This is also fact. Okay, so we need to make these sentences in simple present tense if these are facts and cannot be changed. The next use of simple present is the permanent facts. The permanent facts, or you can say the long lasting fact, okay, that cannot be changed in near future, are called, we have to make the sentences in simple present only. So permanent fact will be permanent facts, or you can call long lasting facts. Like my grandpa, you can say my father works in a bank. My father works in a bank. So here, this is the long lasting fact of the action, isn't it? This is the permanent fact. Okay, my father is not going to change the post or change the job the next day only. It's going to be long lasting, it's going to be for a long time. So that's why we have to make this sentence in simple present tense. Like, he lives in Delhi. He lives in Delhi. So this is a permanent fact, going to be the long lasting fact. That's why we have made this sentence in simple present tense. And the next use is to be going, very important, and that is your habits, you can say, and your routine activities. Okay, what you do repeatedly every day, you need to make the sentences in simple present tense of these activities, like your routine activities. Routine activities. Okay, so like he drinks a glass of milk every day. So you know this is the routine, okay, of taking a glass of milk every day. So you have to use their simple present tense, the habits, the routine activities, and the actions which you do repeatedly. Okay, these sentences you have to make in simple present tense. This is the most important use of simple present tense. You should know about it. So, next we are going to see at the uses we have seen. We have to see now that how to use this tense in sentences. We should know about it, how to identify, because how will you identify the tense? Okay, so each tense has its particular identification, and you have to identify the tense by helping verb or main verb of each tense. So what we have to use here, and how will you identify, how will you use simple present tense only in the sentences, that you have to see now. So how you will use this, what is the structure of the tense will be. So first of all, we are going to do affirmative sentences types, you know already. So affirmative sentences we are going to do. How you make affirmative sentences in simple present tense? So first of all, you have to use subject. Okay, after subject, this is important. You have to use a V1 there. V1 is first form of the verb. Next, you need to look if the subject is singular. The subject is a singular, then you have to add S or ES in the verb. And after this, you need to write the object. So this is the structure of simple present tense in affirmative sentence. So you can see the example. They like to play. They like to play. Okay. Whatever, football, cricket, whatever you need to write. They like to play football. Now you have to see the subject is plural here. But if we need to write singular subject here, then what you need to do here, we have written the singular subject here, he. If you have written a singular subject, then what is the condition here? You have to add S or ES in the verb, the end of the verb. So the subject is singular here, so we need to write add here S. He likes to play football. Okay, but the question is this, we have understood this. If our subject is he, she, it, or anyone's name, singular name. Okay, so if anybody's name is there, then in the verb you have to add S or ES. Now the question is this, there are two suffix, either S or ES. How will you come to know whether you need to add S or ES there? So look at it. If the verb ends in O, CH, SH, X, double S, then you have to add there ES. Okay, and if the verb doesn't end in these words, then simply you have to add S there. But remember, these suffix will be added when the subject is singular here. Like he goes, okay, he goes to school. Now you see, why did we add here ES? So first of all, you have to look at the subject. The subject is singular. It means we have to add there whether S or ES. Okay. But here you see, the last letter of the verb is O. Okay. That's why we didn't add S here. That's why we have added here ES. Okay. Simply like see. Reach. See, reach there. On time. At time. In time. So, look at it. The subject is singular. So, it's definite we have to add there whether S or ES. But what we have to add here? For that, you need to look at the last letters of the verb. And the last letter is here. CH. CH is there, so no doubt, undoubtedly, we have to add here ES. Okay, so just as friends, you need to look if the subject is singular in the verb V1, you need to add S or ES. And if the subject is plural, it's a simple structure. You have to write there subject plus V1 plus object. So this is going to be the identification of simple present tense. If you find there V1, okay, plus S or ES, the tense will be simple present tense. Just remember one more thing. If you find is, am, are in a tense without V4, without V4, that is also going to be simple present tense. Okay, students, so mistakenly they say it's a present continuous tense. Okay, if V4 is not there just after these verbs, it's going to be simple present tense, like I am happy. I am happy. So it's exactly no ing form is there, no V4 is there. So it's a V1. That's why it's going to be simple present tense. And why do we do so? And why do we call this simple present tense? It happens because these is a V form and is am are V1. Is am are the V1 of V form, and both verb will be V2. shall be will be like this. We have to use. So this is the V1. Okay. So we have to call this a simple present tense only. Don't be confused here. If V4 is not there, just simply you need to say it's a simple present tense. And if you find V4 there, like I am writing. So V4 is there, ing is there. So it's going to be continuous tense. You can't see now here. It's a simple present tense. So that was the structure of affirmative sentence. Next, we are going to do negative sentence. Negative. So what we have to use here in negative sentence? Listen, in negative sentence, we have to use not. Isn't it? A sentence which makes negative sense is called a negative sentence. So, and there is a condition of not. Not is always preceded by helping verb. Okay, it always come at the third place. It will come at the third place and it will be always preceded by a helping verb. Matlab iske just pehle helping verb honi chahiye, otherwise the sentence will be wrong. But we haven't used any helping verb in simple present tense in affirmative sentence. But we have to use here in a negative sentence. Like in negative sentence mein hume helping verb use करनी पड़ेगी क्योंकि नोट ही कंडीशन होती है दैट इट विल कम एट द थर्ड प्लेस. सो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू व्हाट द स्ट्रक्चर विल बी. ओके सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू नीड टू राइट देयर सब्जेक्ट देन हेल्पिंग वर्ब. व्हाट द हेल्पिंग वर्ब यू हैव टू यूज हियर डू एंड डज. डू एंड डज जस्ट आफ्टर दिस यू हैव टू राइट नॉट एट थर्ड प्लेस. अब थर्ड प्लेस पे नॉट आ गया है. नेक्स्ट वन इज V1 एंड आफ्टर दिस यू हैव टू राइट योर ऑब्जेक्ट एंड full stop. Now the question is this, where you have to use do and does. With plural noun, with plural subject you have to use do and with singular subject you have to use does. So look at, we will take the same example, okay. Like he goes to school. So this is an affirmative sentence. Now we have to make the negative sentence of this. So what do we have to do? He. Is it singular or plural? He is singular here. So we have to use here does. Does. Next at the third place, not. Now we have to write V1. Now you see, if you have added here does, okay, you don't need to add S or ES in the verb now because already we have added here into. So simply you need to write here now go only, not goes. So he does not go to school. This is the negative sentence now. Okay, if you have to make a plural form, they go to school. They go to school. Now you see, this is plural subject. That's why we haven't added as we as here. So here you need to use here do not. They do not go to school. And dear student, this is the identification of simple present tense do and does. If a sentence consists of do, does, the tense will be simple present tense. And if the sentence consists of V1 or else or ES, then also the tense will be simple present tense. Just remember the identification of all the tenses. How will you identify the tenses? The next one we are going to do is interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences. So, what an interrogative sentence which is used to ask a question is called interrogative sentence. So, there are two types of interrogative sentences: yes or no questions or WH questions. So, how will you form these? So, just to remember, you know the structure of interrogative sentence. Just here, students, interrogative as well as negative, both the sentences require helping verb. Without helping verb, you can form neither interrogative nor negative. So here also we require the helping verb, and the same helping verb we have to use here do and does because we are doing simple present tense. In simple present we have to use do and does. And what is the structure of negative interrogative sentences? You know very well. need to write it actually there. After this, you need to write subject, then V1, and after this, object, whatever adjective and verb, whatever is there, just you need to write, and at last you have to mark question mark. And if you form the sentence of WH word, just you have to write WH word, then actually we have to use here. Actually will be here, do and does, and main verb will be here, V1. Okay, and then object, whatever, and then question mark. Okay, so just to remember, if you start the sentence with helping verb, just you have to start with do and does. Like, do you go to school? Do you go to school? Okay, and question mark. So just to see the structure, actually, first we start in helping verb, then subject. What is subject over here? You is subject here. The next one is V1. We have written V1 here. And to school is the adverbial phrase here. So leave it. The next one is WH question. How will you form WH question? So you can ask the WH, where do you go? Where do you go? Okay. And this is a question only. My main concern is this, most of the students do not use helping verb in the sentence and they form the question there. So it is not called a question. The correct formation of a question is just, first of all, you need to put WH word, then helping verb, then subject, and then your main verb. So that is going to be the structure of interrogative sentence in simple present tense. So if you are going to make interrogative sentence in simple present tense, just first of all you have to write either helping verb, then subject. Helping verb will be do and does, main verb will be V1 and object. And if your question starts with WH word, write WH word, then helping verb means do and does, then V1, then object. So this is going to be your class. Now I'll ask you one question, okay? Just you have to find out the errors in the sentences. You have to look the errors in the sentences. What the errors I have made in these sentences, you have to find out. Okay. Raghu want to go out. The next one is, you have to write these sentences correctly, okay? Why you write this? Okay, so this is interrogative sentence, just to find out what the mistake is there, something missing can be there, okay? Some sentences I have written wrongly, mistake can be there, you need to correct. So, and the next one is he do not know it. He do not know it. The fourth one is you have to correct these four sentences, okay? And you have to write the correct sentences there. And dear students, what's your homework going to be? This is not at all only your homework. You have to do this as well as one more thing you have to do. You have to tell me the daily routine. Means what is your routine during this quarantine or during this lockdown? You need to make a video here, okay? You have to use the sentences. Okay, you need to make here your video, record it, and you have to share this on your WhatsApp group. Remember, you are going to write your routine activities, your daily activities. So all the sentences, whatever you are going to speak in your videos, should be in simple present tense only. Thank you.